and just like that, he's gone. Rutis says, Ruka, Ruka, hold on. Sister, Rutis, you came back for me. I'm here. Your sister is right here. Castle says, those guys have come to see me several times already. They're asking us to produce weapons using a very rare ore called rare metal. It looks like you read a book about that quite a while ago. Eleanor says, I've heard of rare metal before. It is a light, strong material receptive to spell power. Castle says, besides the difficulty refining the metal itself, I couldn't oblige with their request because I knew they were going to use the weapons for evil purposes. And that is what you told them, yes. Little did I know they would retaliate us in such a devastating manner. Eleanor says, your decision was correct, plant manager. The user of any spell or technology must have an ethical mind. Don't blame yourself. Avon asks, hey, are you leaving? Rutis says, I know he is safe now. I didn't know you were Ruka's sister. Why did you join Octum's apostles? I don't think you would understand. You don't know what Ruka and I had to go through after leaving our village. Our mission is to purify this imperfect, ugly world and create a utopia where people can live happily. I'm working to help achieve that mission. Cut the crap, says Avon. If Ruka dies, do you still call this world a utopia? Since you save Ruka, I won't take your cabeza. I also give you the information I just learned. A girl with red hair was sighted in Balloa. What? Yells Avon. You'd better hurry. Hey, Rutis! Avon, says Ruka. Rail says, Ruka, good! You've been unconscious. Is my sister gone? Yeah, says Avon. I don't know what to say. Ruka says, please don't look at me like that. I'm so happy just to know my sister is alive. Right, of course. Just to know she is alive. Avon, please go to Balloa quickly. You must meet ML this time. You're right. I'll do that. Heal your injury and get well soon. Miles says, if we see your sister again, we'll persuade her to come back. Thank you. Avon? Mile? Rail says, I don't know if Ruka's okay. I'm worried about him. Eleanor says, he must be confused after what happened. We should leave him alone for now. We'll visit him after a while. Avon says, Rail, Professor Eleanor, please take good care of Ruka. Ah, don't tell us they're leaving us. Leave it to us, says Eleanor. Don't worry, you two head for Balloa. I knew they were leaving. I didn't think Rail was leaving so soon. I'm worried about Ruka, but I also want to go with Avon and Mile. I don't know what to do. You must attend school, young man. Don't think you can get away by taking advantage of the situation. Was it that obvious, says Rail? Mile says, anyway, we'll be traveling together a little while. Yes, says Eleanor. We should leave now. Oh, they're still with us? Okay, for now. Balloa we're supposed to be going to? Oh, which is west. Okay. First, of course, we're gonna run all over and talk to everybody. I'm assuming people will be back to our... to their, respective houses and stuff. Restoration work is underway inside. I'm sorry, but unauthorized personnel can't enter the factory for a while. I wonder when we will be able to resume the operation. Did you chase away the attackers? I was unconscious and don't remember anything. Thank you. You are our saviors. I guess we told them yes. Well, let's check down here. Mm. You did such a great service for us. Thank you for helping us kill the monsters. By the way, Plant Manager Castle sent us a reward for you. 2,000 rows. See, this is why you look all over the place, guys, and talk to everybody. Avon says, we can't take it. The factory was destroyed. I'm sure they need this more than we do. Okay then, I'll return the roses to the plant manager. Meister says, just take it. You'll hurt his feelings if you don't. Buy fine weapons and help those in trouble. Alright, we'll take the money then. Miles says, send our regards to the plant manager. Are you leaving? Do come back to Guia if you have time. We'll be looking forward to hearing of your heroic deeds. Yeah, along with the writer. We'll run into him again. Alright, so we got 2,000 rows. That's nice. Yeah, let's see if there's anything new, since we got money now. Just taking a quick look to see if there's any obvious increase here. Everything puts us down a little bit. Oh, I'm moving around this one. Didn't someone need... Okay, that moves it. Yeah, metal jacket. We'll get a full metal jacket for Eleanor. What is she using? Let me just give that to her. Let's see what she's has equipped. She's using a flail. Okay, she does have a shield. Okay. Fruit witch. It's a funny name. Alright, so we already have a light flail for her. We'll sell this light flail. Chainmail. That's what she had. Alright, so as far as a shield, I think the Tonki is the best? Oh no, the kite shield's better. Buy her a kite shield. And what about, I think the battle axe, not as good as it really. That's what Rail has. I'm surprised the kite shield is better than a fine shield. Kite shield is usually small shield. Alright, so we're selling the fine shield. Now, right, she uses the maces. We have all have metal jackets. Great sword, cross blades, light flail, and Celtis or Celtis, whatever. Is there nothing better than a light flail? Like a fine flail or something? It brings her defense down, probably because it's two-handed, I would think. Same here. Miles using cross blades. Yeah, I say that's good. See you again. Maybe. Stinking tools. I can do my business thanks to you. I truly appreciate what you have done. Oops. Down there. Hi there, welcome. Hey, I know you. You are the heroes who saved the town. Would you like to eat at my place? We're rude, so we won't answer you. Look, now they spell maggot different. I swear it was spelled differently. It was spelled M-A-G-G-O-T. Both in what the people were saying and the little character name that appears on the left-hand side. Professor Maggot is sleeping. Wait. Please hear me out. Professor Eleanor, there is a reason. I wonder what kind of dream he is seeing, says Eleanor. We may never know. Professor Eleanor, your student is such a talent. He may be young, but he is a full-fledged sorcerer. Ahem, Rail says. Eleanor says, please don't flatter him too much. He's just a kid inside. What are you saying, says Rail. I'm serious. You should train him with extra care. I'm sure he will become a great sorcerer in the future. You said he's a great sorcerer now. Ahem. As I have expected, adventurers are truly trustworthy. Lightning Douglas was also a dependable man. Do you know Douglas? Asked Haven. He helped me when I was attacked by monsters on the highway. I'm surprised that you know him. We used to work together, says Mile. Really? It's a small world. After all, Douglas is a good man, but I shouldn't have offered him a drink. He gobbled down the entire thing. You want him to drink it slowly? As long as he enjoyed it, that's all that matters. Without you, Guia would have been in great trouble. Thank you very much. Not gonna bother with her. Whoever we talked to over here is gone. I don't even remember who it was. Oops. You are Avon and Mile, right? Thank you for rescuing the workers at the factory. I can refer you the best girls as a token of my appreciation. Avon says, we did what anyone should have done in that situation. Mile says, please don't be obliged. Adventurers don't have steady income, but the guild is managed directly by the royal family. The credibility of the guild's adventurers is much higher than you think. You are perfect candidates. Avon says, please tell that to a man named Douglas. Alright, I don't think there's anyone down here. Let's just look. I can read the books again. I assume it's the same ones. Need easy recipe with eggs. Thank you to whoever left the one like on Recipe with Eggs 1 and 2. You're awesome. Really only reading them to say that I can read every book. That I have read every book. Kind of ridiculous to read them out loud, but what can you do? Alright, so we've looked at everything that way. Let's go check in on everybody. Nothing down here, right? As far as people. Thank you. You saved our lives. By the way, I was pretty tired after carrying out steel. I can't believe I was able to run this much. People can demonstrate enormous power when driven to a corner. Yeah, it's called adrenaline. But I don't want to be in that situation again, ever. Ever, I tell you. It's locked. That's where the whatever that took over that old lady was there. Why? What were the gatekeepers doing to let the monsters enter so easily? They should pay more attention. They weren't coming in through the gate. The guy was summoning them. Got a clue, lady. The next door neighbor had their door broken by monsters, so I repaired it for them. Now old woman Rayo owes me big time. Yeah, I wonder where the real old woman Rayo is. Oh, Rayo, sorry. Sorry, Rayo. Maruru was bit by a monster and injured her leg. I'm very worried. Darn it, says Avon. How dare they hurt a little child? I wish we were here sooner, says Mile. Josie says, my mother said the she would fix Maruru. Okay. Your mother would fix Maruru, says Avon. What is Maruru exactly, says Mile. It's a stuffed jackrabbit. Bartus, please make my Maruru recover quickly. Oh god, stuffed jackrabbit. Whew, I'm exhausted. I just finished cleaning up the house after the monsters trashed everything. I guess everyone has their little cleanup act to do. My husband came home early. I should cheer up and make dinner. I must prepare a meal quickly. Oh, let him wait. You're not his step and fetch it. I came dashing from deep in the mine after hearing that monsters had attacked the town. When I got here, everything was over. Darn. I feel so useless. So help make dinner, you lazy bag of bones. Anyway, what were the gatekeepers doing? We can trust those rowdy miners a lot more. Okay. I was very scared when I heard the explosion from the factory. There were rumors that suspicious-looking men were visiting the factory, but I didn't think a disaster like this would happen. I'm glad my father was unhurt. Oh, what you got? I threw it away. I don't need it, blast you. I don't need it. There's that guy. The HF1 furnace was in terrible shape. We decided to design a new one from scratch. We're making design drawings in a great hurry. We must finish the design as soon as possible. This is also for Ruka, who tried to save the furnace. Okay. I wish you luck with your endeavors. Alright, is that everything? Everyone? Alright, so West is Balloa. We need to go below. Balloa. West. Not that west. Says, well, you must say goodbye here. I don't want Eleanor to leave. She's awesome. Professor, Avon says, can I ask you one last question?
What is it?
I hope I have an answer for it.
Do you know anything about Durga's daughter?
Durga's daughter. It's a term used in several ancient manuscripts. It refers to a female medium sent by the god of spirits to mediate for the human world.
What do you want to know about it?
Well, here's what I really want to ask. Suppose there is Durga's daughter, and she's being chased by the Octum Apostles. Why are they after her? Get up and notice the music just stopped. It's a very specific question, she says. Durga is considered the mother of spirits. At the same time, she is also the gatekeeper of Hades. It is said that Bardas sealed Octum at the bottom of Hades, where no light can reach. I think it has something to do with Durga's daughter being chased.
Octum sleeps in Hades, says Mile.
Durga's daughter is a mediator for Durga, who is the gatekeeper of Hades.
It makes sense.
Yeah, says Avon. Eleanor says, is it Imel, who disappeared from the Ice Palace? Is she... Avon nodded silently.
I see. I didn't know the magnitude of the situation.
Rail says, I changed my mind. I'll come with you. I can help you with my spell power.
Thanks, says Avon, but you have something to do first.
You can join us after you've completed your mission.
Miles says, work hard and become a great sorcerer. When you do, we will be waiting.
Well, if you say so.
It's a promise, right?
Avon says, yeah, it's a promise between men.
Eleanor says, Avon, Mile, please be careful on your journey. I hope you'll find Imel in Balloa.
Rael says, bye, partners.
The search in Guia began with an encounter with a little sorcerer, and ended in a way no one had expected. As if operated by invisible threads, various people revealed themselves and left just as fast as they came.
You got that right.
Not being able to put together the scattered pieces of the puzzle, and being guided by fate, Avon and Mile headed for Balloa, the port town at the western edge of the Boreas region.
They sure did.
West.
Go west, young men.
Now, where is it from here? Down this way?
Tear Bridge? Am I supposed to be crossing this?
Avon says, huh?
Mile says, are they travelers?
Who dat?
A well-dressed man says, hi there. Did you come from Guia?
Yes, Avon says, may I help you?
I heard that monsters had attacked Guia. Could you tell me the extent of damage?
Well, says Mile, some people were injured, but nothing serious.
That's good. I hate to see people suffer.
Avon says, a bomb exploded in a plant and several facilities were completely destroyed. They say the plant will be closed for a while.
A young sailor says, that's bad news.
I was going to place an order for ship parts. I guess that's not possible.
What are you going to do, then? You want to go back to Balloa?
No. I'll visit the plant to see how they're doing, the sailor says. I know them well.
All right. We should hurry and get to Guia, then. Thank you for the information.
The sailor says, if you're heading for Balloa, be careful. The number of monster sightings has increased lately. Okay. That was kind of random. Miles says, they were a strange duo. Yeah, says Avon. The gentleman seemed to be in control, and the young sailor seemed to be very skilled. Skilled in what? Sailing? How could you tell from him walking around? Miles says, I wonder who they are.
Maybe someday we'll find out. Get back here, you.
So I guess we're heading in the right way. Right direction.
I do not need that stinking crap.
I hope I'm heading the right way. East is Guia, west Balloa, south is Silver Mine. Silver Mine this way. Road to Richness? Well, I'm pretty sure we're not supposed to be going this way yet, but let's just take a look. Oh! Nice! 500 rows, yeah, that makes sense. Road to Richness. Find something useful, will ya? Dead in there. Just looking right now. You're finding a lot of crap. More crap. Miner says, hey, what are you doing here? This is Balloa's silver mine. Nobody told me we'd have new workers. You're mistaken, says Avon. We just got lost. That's too bad. We were short-handed and looking for people. Would you like to work for a while, now that you're here? No thanks, says Mile. Ha ha ha. I'll be waiting if you change your mind. We better not, says Mile. We have no time to work in the mine. We'll be back for some reason, I'm sure. Not gonna put a mine there and just have us never go to it. Excuse me. Almost had an encounter there. Wait. Where? Oh, okay, never mind. That's right. The sign's up here, right? Yeah. Alright, so it's west, right? Yeah. Pardon me. Coming through. South Balloa. Alright. So stay tuned for next episode, guys, when we enter and take a look around in Balloa. I'm saying that right. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.